Does Persona 3 need a remake? Let's talk about it. Well, honestly, to me, it would boil down to what your definition of needs is. Persona 3 is probably the most interesting Persona that I've played. I've only played 3, Persona 4 for a little bit, Persona 4 Golden, and then Persona 5 Royal and Strikers. But Persona 3 has these two completely different versions of itself, with Fez and Portable, that both have their pros and cons and offer a different experience to one another while trying to tell at least mostly the same story. Portable is the one that received the ports recently, and I'm playing Portable right now on the PS5. And there are various aspects of Portable that I prefer over Fez, just straight up, from the little that I've played of Fez. The big contender is the combat, which we'll get to in a minute. But there's other aspects to it, such as not running around the main hubs or the main open-world-esque areas, such as around Polonia Mall, the school, and whatnot, the dorm as well. Whereas instead, in Portable, you have this top-down, almost isometric view, where you're just controlling a cursor, selecting characters to talk to, and stuff like this, and everything just feels far more akin to a visual novel than it does to a Persona RPG. And that was useful when this game was on a PlayStation Portable, because it fit that style of game very well. It fit what you probably want to get out of that device, and the way you want to interact with that device, in a way that was conducive to that hardware. But now that we're playing on the PS5, it's a bit jarring going from, say, P4 Golden, or P5, or P5 Royal, back to P3. Some things have obviously aged, and the story is still fantastic from what I've played of it. But a lot of the time, it will come down to personal preference. And the fact that we have these two drastically different versions, with Fez and Portable, where I don't think there's any one, quote-unquote, definitive edition for Persona 3, because they both offer their own unique pros and cons that the other just doesn't. You could argue Persona 3 Fez brings to the table the answer, along with additional changes from the base game Persona 3, and you would be right. I would counter by saying that I'm not personally a big fan of the answer. But with Portable, what you get instead is the option to play as the female protagonist, which offers different social links, different dialogue options, I believe, and just overall a different experience. And to many people who like to play a role-playing game, having that option to play as a different protagonist is very appealing to them. To me, I'm here or there on it. I'm fine with just playing as Makoto here. But one of the big things for me with Portable is what you're seeing right here. The fact you can actively choose what you want each party member to do in combat. It's not relegated to a priority system like it was in Persona 3 and Persona 3 Fez, where you just told each party member, where is it? Oh, it's in its tactics, where essentially you can just choose what tactics they do, but you don't have direct control over them. With Persona 3 Portable, you do have direct control. I say, hey, Akihiko, I want you to use a Sonic Punch on this Phantom Mage for the lulz. It's far more akin to a combat system along the lines of, say, P4 or P4 Golden. And to me, that is far more appealing than what is brought to the table with P3 Fez. Oh, the crit there? Let's go. Let's go, another crit. Like I said, the combat of P3 Portable to me is more appealing and more engaging and more enjoyable than what is brought to the table with Fez. However, the story that is brought with Fez is more appealing to me just because of the nature of how you interact with it. I like the act of walking around these locations. I like having these fully cinematic cutscenes. I find them far more engaging and a better tool to deliver the story of P3 than, say, the animated PowerPoint presentation that they do with P3 Portable. There's also a bunch of little outdated design philosophies that were brought to the table with P3 back in the day that they kind of phased out over time. One of which is the nature of which you interact with the Velvet Room. Now, let's go back there. And let me show you what I'm talking about very quickly. We go over here. First of all, this mechanic, where I can just say heal the party, I don't need to worry about the Fox social link. Goated. Love this thing. But we go into the Velvet Room. Fuse personas. If I say I want to fuse Alp with, Oberon. Let's say Oberon. Cool. In the other games, you would have normally some way to interact with what spells get carried over. What skills, get carried over to the new persona. You don't get that, really, with P3. And it's kind of annoying, but you can work around it a little bit, but it's just an added layer of friction that I don't think really adds all that much to the experience outside of just making things a little bit more difficult. And the other thing, for me, goes down here with requests, undertaking a quest. Now, Persona 4 Golden also had a quest system, but in that game, you weren't limited to the number of ones you could actually take at any given time. It's not that big of an issue, and you could argue that there is some value to the system in terms of having to prioritize what you think you'll be able to accomplish easier or first, or trying to prioritize the deadline-esque missions instead of the ones you can do whenever. You can make that argument. However, I would counteract it with... I would honestly just prefer being able to do all the quests at any given time that I can, and just turn them in like that. If you're going to give me a lot of side quests to do, having to come back every three quests to turn them in and get new ones isn't all that appealing to me instead of the satisfaction that I get personally by turning in a whole bunch of quests at the same time. I feel like it's a nice, big, chunky accomplishment that you can just turn in whenever. I like that. It's a personal thing at the end of the day. But it's one of these, in my opinion, dated game design philosophies that is incorporated with P3 because it's an old game. We have to understand that. P3 is an old game. And to me, what Portable is here to do, and the reason they selected Portable as the one to port, was maybe Fez was just too difficult because it was on the PS3, and for those who don't know, the architecture of the PS3 is like trying to do origami with a piece of sheet metal. It's really hard to actually work with that, from what I've heard. And also the combat system. The combat system being the main one, because you have a lot of new Persona fans that have joined the series with P4 back in the day, P4 Golden, and then largely P5 and P5 Royal, that are going to come back to P3 because they want to play more Persona games, and now they have access to them. Do you want them to be exposed to P3 Portable's combat system that's more akin to what you can find in, say, P4 Golden, where you can control all the party members, or have that added level of friction where you can't control the party members and just frustrate a lot of people who aren't used to that kind of difficulty. Also, P3P has difficulty modes. That's another thing. I don't remember, so don't quote me on that one. But to me, the combat system is probably the main reason where if Atlas had to look at Fez and Portable and they were both equally viable to be ported, I would probably still argue to port Portable if you're only going to do one of them just because of the combat system and the changes that were taking place in the combat system. But to me, what Portable feels like to me is testing the waters to see if people would be receptive to a remake of this game. Or at least, not necessarily to see if they're receptive to it, but to at least put Persona 3 back in the cultural zeitgeist of Persona that's out there right now. Get people more aware with its story, characters, and stuff like that. So if they do an eventual Persona 3 remake announcement, more people would probably care about it because we involve characters that they already know and love. That could be a factor too, in my opinion. There have been more rumors, especially at the beginning of the year. We had all those rumors come out about a Persona 3 remake being in the works. It would not surprise me if it comes out before P6. And I feel this is just the overall direction they're taking. So, does Persona 3 need a remake? It kind of depends upon what you define and in terms of need. For me, you have these two versions that aren't necessarily the definitive edition compared to one another. They both have their pros and cons depending upon what you're looking for. And to me, if you can make a remake style, a remake of Persona 3, but up the graphical fidelity, put in more in line with, say, P5 or P5 Royal, but keep that P3 charm and P3P's combat system, but with Fez's, maybe even updated cutscenes and stuff like that. Maybe just flesh out some social links, add some rewards here and there, make Tartus a little bit more engaging. Just changes and tweaks here and there. I feel that this could be a very valuable remake, in my opinion. I would love to see what they could do if they took a crack at it. And to me, that's why I believe Persona 3 is wanting a remake, but I don't necessarily think it absolutely needs one. Because again, needing is a bit of a extreme definition at times. But to me, I think I would really like to see one. So I'm going to call the video there for the day. Thank you all for tuning in. My pleasure making the video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out and helps support future content, and I greatly appreciate it. Stay safe with everybody. Have a great day, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye, everybody.